He sees you when you're sleeping, he knows when you're awake, and he knows when you've been bad or good, and you know who I'm talking about, and no, not Mark Zuckerberg, I'm talking about Father Christmas, Kris Kringle, Saint Nick, the big man himself, Santa, and I'm reviewing how he affects video game prices. Welcome to a new episode of Retronomics, the series that follows trends in video game prices and other financial impacts of the gaming industry. I've done a number of episodes on how specific people influence video game prices, my most successful one being Metal Jesus Rocks, but let's dive in a little bit deeper on how a specific time of year affects the prices. Christmas started in the year zero, where three wise men presented Jesus with some frankincense and myrrh, but we would have to wait over 1900 years to have the first video game system gifted under a Christmas tree. While most video games gifted are brand new, it is becoming a little bit more acceptable to give something like a used vintage video game. While my wife tends to gift me some vintage games, mostly I use cash that I get from my grandparents and use that towards video games that I want. So for this video, I did some research on a handful of games that I have covered in the past, and I took a look at the prices in November, December, and January from 2014 to 2018. And I also looked at system prices overall. All of my data is from pricecharting.com, and it's important to note that the prices on the site are not just an average price during that time. There are other estimators like the most recent sale price, the median price, an average price, and many more. And this makes the prices more of a market value. So with that out of the way, let's take a look at some video game prices, and let's start out with the consoles. Overall, not a lot of changes. The NES didn't change at all over the past five Christmases, and same thing with the PlayStation 1, 2, and 3. So I think it's safe to say that overall, the prices aren't affected, so let's take a look at individual games. Now, choosing the games was pretty tricky. Obviously, I can't go into all of them, but I didn't just want to choose the most expensive games like Little Samson. I mean, if you're getting $1,000 gifts pretty regularly, then man, I'm looking to be adopted. So instead, I focused on some popular games ranging from under $10 to under $100. And as a control, I chose a couple of different eras of video games: NES, SNES, Sega Genesis, PlayStation 2, Nintendo 64, and the GameCube, just to avoid maybe thinking that one system was popular that year. So what did I find out? Well, the difference in price for all 15 games from November into December varied, but the majority of the games that I charted did increase in value for each December. In 2017, only 8 out of the 15 games increased in value in December, but 7 decreased in value, and this is the closest margin of all the years that I tracked. And most of the time it was an 80-20 split, so I'm not sure what happened in 2017 to cause this, especially since in 2018 the prices went back up to that 80-20 split. 2014 had the most games with the price increases over $20, and the rest of the year's price increases less than $10, and then in 2018, most games increased less than $5. And this could be a sign that game collecting in general is slowing down, although prices still increase overall during the Christmas season. Then, when you take a look at the games individually, only 3 games increased in value all 5 Christmases, 7 increased 4 Christmases, 2 only 3 Christmases, and 2 games increased only 2 Christmases, and then 1 game, Mr. Mosquito, only increased in value for 1 Christmas, and then the rest of the Christmases, it dropped in value. So what can we conclude by this? Well, I mean, I think it's pretty clear that Christmas is a time where a lot of people buy games more frequently, so it makes sense that the more popular a game is, the more likely people are willing to pay more to ensure that those video games are under the Christmas tree on December 25th. Also, consider that the prices for January drop back down to November levels, so it's clearly some correlation between the time that these games are purchased and the price increases. So does Santa actually affect the prices? Well, yeah, I mean, people spend a lot of money on Christmas gifts, so it's reasonable to assume that some of that money is put into the game collecting economy as well. So if you are planning on buying video games for yourself, it's probably a good idea to buy them in September or October, and then if he can't, then wait until January or February to start buying again, just to save some extra dollars. I'm not sure what this Christmas will look like, but as I was looking over the prices, it does appear that video game prices are going to rise again for Christmas 2019. How much that will go up is still up for debate, and let me know what you think in the comments below. And that's gonna wrap it up for this episode of Retronomics. If you liked this video, give it a like, it really helps the video find new audience. And if you're new here, I have a ton of episodes of Retronomics for you to enjoy, like how Metal Jesus Rocks affects video game prices, to how limited run games trend over time. I also discuss game collecting topics, so if that's what you're into, consider subscribing for future content. Thanks so much for watching, I'm Super Nicktendo, and I'll see you next time.